Hey, what's up guys? Alex with Bay Cities Construction here. We're at our job in beautiful Harbor City. And we're working on our soft story retrofit here. I want to kind of walk you through what we've gotten done so far. So let's look up here real quick. We've peeled up all of the diaphragm framing, you know. We put in a new beam in here. We're gonna change the camera angle so you can see it. But basically, this is all part of the retrofit process. Installation of plywood shear on the outside of the building, right? It's gonna create lateral strength this way and this way. Check this out, look at these big beams we put in here. So this is all new. This new strap ties everything in. This goes all the way to here. We're gonna put in two rows of 2 foot long Simpson strong walls. So that's the backing for the Simpson strong walls. They're gonna be here where this kind of pile of dirt's gonna get removed. And we're gonna use that plywood over there. That's all structural one plywood. So we're gonna go over to this other side. I'm gonna show you what's happening on this side of the building. This section here, we're doing some more diaphragm framing, and basically it's quite a bit. It's about 40 feet of diaphragm framing, and again we're just putting plywood here. This is going to help create a shear resistance for earthquake. Let's show you what's happening inside the garage. Let me get this out of your way. This is our scaffolding. So back here I wanted to show you our new shear wall. Buildings are soft two ways. They're soft this way, we're gonna put a moment frame over there, and it's soft this way. In order to deal with this lateral resistance, we're putting in a piece of shear wall. So basically this is about 5 feet. It's a little bit bigger than the specs. It's spec'd out at 5 feet, we did about 6 feet, because we got a better connection here. So we got a big 4x8. This is gonna be all shear wall, tied in up there, and then bolted down with a big 24 inch deep bolt. So you can see it's pretty significant. Hold on 1 second, don't go. Every retrofit requires hardware, and we have no lack of it here. This is a all thread rod. This bad boy goes there. This is actually gonna get embedded in concrete. It's nice, sturdy, and it creates tension with a Simpson hood. It goes like that. This goes on your wall. This anchors down to the ground. Now you're ready for rock and roll. 835s. This is absolutely required in soft story retrofitting. Hey, let's go to this side of the building. Follow me. Okay, now we're in this side of the building. That took forever, didn't it? It is kind of a big building. So this part, we're doing the same thing as we're doing on the opposite part. We're peeling this back and exposing it so we can put diaphragm framing. So this whole area here is gonna be covered with plywood, and we're gonna put a set of beams like we did on the other side right up here. We haven't put it in yet. This is what it looks like now. If you have a building that's similar to this, you're gonna have these 2x12s, 16 on center, the entire length of the building. And at the end, basically, at the end of the buildings to create shear resistance this way, the moment frame is gonna cover us this way. But we need shear resistance this way. So these beams right here are basically gonna tie this to this to the new Simpson strong wall deal we're gonna put here. That's gonna go into the ground. And when we come back and we cut the concrete, it's gonna be a lot of fun. This whole area here is gonna be cut. We're gonna connect the foundation of that post with our new shear walls that will be right here. Together, it's not gonna be soft anymore. It's gonna be retrofitted. So that's how we do a retrofit. This building is gonna have a moment frame. So we're gonna show you where that's gonna go, but we haven't peeled back the stucco, so there's nothing to see yet. We're extremely excited to use the Simpson special moment frame. And yes, it is special. We're gonna put a Simpson special moment frame on the other side of the building. That's gonna give us our lateral resistance this way. So the strong walls that are going over there gives us lateral resistance this way, and then we're gonna make the building stiff that way. So really excited to show you what that's gonna look like. It's gonna be cool. We'll make sure we shoot some footage when we cut the concrete and jackhammer the slabs down. That's my favorite part. I love jackhammering. We got a brand new Bosch saw, and we are gonna cut this bad boy down. We're gonna cut a big old trench all the way down to the wall. And for the moment, friend, we get to cut two of them. It's gonna be an L-shaped cut. So stay tuned, that's our update for our Lomita Harbor City project. And stay tuned, make sure you subscribe. And hey, if you have any questions about your building, getting it retrofitted, give my offices a call. My name's Alex with Bay Cities Construction. I'll see you on the field. Remember, you don't need a contractor. You need a team of pros.